Now, for those of you who have the pleasure of not knowing who I am, my name is Kieran McLoughlin. I have the privilege of being the president of the American Ireland Fund, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the 36th annual American Ireland Fund New York Dinner Gala. You're all very welcome. Thank you. And in a complete break with tradition, I intend to be brief tonight. In fact, I intend to adhere to the wisdom of that ancient Irish proverb, stand tall to be seen, shout loudly to be heard, sit down to be appreciated. That said, I'm going to relish my time at the podium. I was only saying to my good lady wife earlier in the evening, you know, sweetheart, would you have ever believed in your wildest dreams that I'd be standing here tonight? And she said, honey, you're not in my wildest dreams. It's tragic, really. And in a further sign of my own insignificance, of all the speakers you're going to hear tonight, mine is the only name I didn't recognize. So let me introduce you to the luminaries you will hear from a little later. We are delighted that our guest of honor is Ireland's Taoiseach, Enda Kenny. Mr. Kenny was elected to the office of Taoiseach on March 9th by the largest majority in the history of the Irish state. And sir, we are very thrilled and very grateful that you took time to travel and be with us here tonight. Thank you. You will also hear from the greatest from Roscommon, Irial Finan, and the greatest of the great from County Clare, Muhammad Ali. I'm also very pleased to tell you that we're joined by Declan Kelly, US Special Envoy for Northern Ireland, Christine Quinn, Speaker of New York City Council, Michael Collins, US Ambassador to Ireland, Noel Kilkenny, Consul General of Ireland to New York. Thank you all. And you're all very, very welcome indeed. I should say Norman Houston, of the Director of the Northern Ireland Bureau, is here as well. And a very special welcome to Dr. Pierce Lyons, founder of Altec and Muhammad and Lani Ali's great, great friend. Thank you all for being here. You're very welcome. Now, in the 1990s, as the Russian economy was crumbling, Boris Yeltsin was asked to comment on the state of that economy. And he responded by saying, good. Rather stunned journalist asked him if he cared to expand on his answer on the state of the Russian economy, to which he responded, not good. Now, the Irish economy is the subject of much speculation currently, and most of it is not good. But let there be no mistake, Ireland will recover, will come roaring back, and will establish ourselves as the comeback kid of Western economies. The signs of that recovery are already there to be seen. The economy is back in growth mode. GDP will expand this year. The export sector is booming with record earnings achieved in 2010. And consider this, Ireland attracts more American foreign direct investment than Brazil, Russia, India, and China combined. That's the reality of Ireland today. That said, the recovery will take time, and as the necessary adjustments take place, real hardship is being felt. And perhaps the most poignant sign of that is that the scourge of Irish society, mass emigration, is back. It is estimated that 100,000 people will leave Ireland over the next 12 months. So the response of the Ireland Funds has been to launch our Promising Ireland campaign to raise $100 million for Irish charities between now and 2013. The title of that campaign, Promising Ireland, was very carefully chosen. It means our pledge to deliver that money, but also our belief in Ireland's future. And its purpose is equally clear. It's to support those charities and individuals that are meeting Ireland's social needs with the greatest innovation, the greatest industry, and the greatest success. Projects in Northern Ireland, such as integrated education, that educate Catholics and Protestants together, still only 6% of the school-going population in the north. Or that wonderful American cultural export, Sesame Street, with its unique way of moulding young minds and promoting tolerance and mutual respect. In the Republic, we're thrilled to be bringing that great, great American not-for-profit Autism Speaks to Ireland for the first venture in that country, along with University College Galway. And also the project we launched here last year with our partners U2 Music Generation, which will transform a situation where musical training is only available to 4% of Irish kids to a position where it becomes a standard subject in the school curriculum. But that's but four of the 200 projects through your help that we support every year. They say a picture tells 1,000 words. So can I ask you just to show, to watch a short video, which will give you a greater flavor of just the impact you're having across Ireland.